the new year. Welcome to a new episode of Music Mondays. I'm Taylor.
I'm Leah.
And this is episode 31.
It is.
We're talking about The Pains of Growing by Alicia Cara.
We are.
She is 22 years old.
Me too. And I'm not doing anything.
She's from Canada.
I'm not.
She's a singer, songwriter, instrumentalist. She got her start by posting covers on YouTube, and she won Best New Artist at the Grammys in 2018. She also sang that Moana song. How far I'll go.
Oh, yeah. Did she? Was it on like a...
Like she did like the end credit song.
Yeah. I was like, it wasn't the one that was actually in the movie, right? It was like the...
I've been staring at the edge of the water. Yep. Right. That one.
We're off to a good start, kids.
She is 156th in the world with monthly listeners. She has 15.1 million monthly listeners on Spotify and roughly 4.4 million Spotify followers.
That's a lot of people. I remember... I don't really listen to her a lot, but I do remember when Wild Things was popular. It was freshman year, and every time, like, I lived in the dorms, and every time I went to take a shower, that song was on the radio. Like, every single time.
Yeah.
So.
That makes sense.
Yeah. I'm a little bit hurt by that song at this point. I've heard it too many times, but.
Yeah. I feel that. Yeah. I understand.
New album was refreshing.
Yeah. New album was very good. Mm-hmm. I put it on my top 10 albums of 2018.
Blog thing.
It's called The Pains of Growing. It was released on November 30th, 2018, and it is her second studio album.
Yeah.
What was your favorite song?
My favorite song was My Kind. I just thought it was really cute. And the one thing that I loved most about this album were the lyrics.
Mm-hmm.
She's a very, very good writer.
Mm-hmm.
And, there was a lot. I mean, I had the entire break to like really listen to and dissect this, and I did not use my time wisely. But that one and where was that? Wherever I Live, that one like also really got me.
Yeah, that one.
Like there
good.
Were some of these songs that I was just like, that one also 7 Days, which was about like, you know, like, God, are you disappointed? Because you should be.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I thought her lyrics were really, really good.
Yeah.
I
really liked, so my favorite was Nintendo Game, because I thought it was really interesting how she, like, compared her relationship mm-hmm. to Nintendo games.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and I like the part where she's like, this is taking longer than Zelda.
Yeah.
Can we just play Rainbow Road? Like,
yeah.
Let's just get this over with, because supposedly, what I had read was she had been in a relationship for, like, 2 or 3 years,
mm-hmm.
A really serious relationship, and according to her lyrics, it sounds like they've broken up.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it wasn't, like, a public, like, hey, we broke up, or, right. like, there was nothing said, but, like, everyone assumes through this album that she's broken up with her first long-term boyfriend.
Yeah. I mean, there's literally a song called Out of Love. Like, when did you fall out of love with me?
Mm-hmm.
You know? Which... Yeah. Sad.
It is
but
sad.
It's like, I know, I felt myself, like, getting really emotional about her songs about breaking up, and I'm like, I am, like, married, pretty
yeah.
much.
Pretty much, yeah. We
so,
both
like,
are
both of us are, like, old married women, yeah. and, yeah.
Yeah. I really like the beginning of Growing Pains, the first track on the album, because it's, like, a, I don't know, it's a good way to start an album.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, like,
and then she ends with the reprise.
Yeah.
I also love the, I was thinking about this, I was listening to it on my way back to school.
Mm-hmm.
I love the, like, electronic-y, like, harmony thing.
Mm-hmm.
And some people are like, that's so artificial. And I'm like,
nah,
get out. Like, just let me like this. I feel like I can really hear my mouth sounds today.
Yeah.
So that was really gross. Sorry.
Sorry for our audio-only listeners.
Yeah. But
what
was your favorite?
Was
oh, you said that already.
Yeah.
We've literally just talked about that for like an hour and a half.
Nintendo games, yeah. There was something that they said on the Pitchfork article that I liked. This album isn't a revelation, but it has the tinge of a project made with love and devotion, a feeling that had more or less evaporated from her music. So I thought that was really neat. Mm-hmm. They gave her a 6.8, which I can't be mad at.
Fine, like, for Pitchfork.
Yeah, you know? That's fine.
That's good for Pitchfork.
Yeah, and she is, like, she's a pop star. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't expect them to give pop artists, like, highest ratings. Like, right. Usually they give best new album to, like, indie artists.
Yeah.
Which makes sense. But
yeah,
I think it's very good for a pop album. I think that there will be a few hits on here.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah, I definitely appreciated how, like, excuse me, I just burped, that was gross. Sorry. How even though it is a pop album, and it does, you know, have remnants of, like, her older stuff, it can appeal to people that don't listen to, you know, like, the hits and all that kind of stuff. There's a lot of depth to it.
Yeah.
And I feel like, you know, I mean, not to slam today's music, but a lot of really popular pop music, there's not a lot of depth to it, which might, you know, maybe I'm just naive, but I don't know. I just don't feel... There's yet to be a... Well, I don't listen to the radio, but it's like I've never once listened to the radio and been like, this song is just hitting me. You know, it's like that's never happened.
Yeah.
So,
I said that this album feels very 22. Like, it feels like something that a 22-year-old would put out.
Yeah.
Like, she's not trying to be older than she is. She's not trying to be younger than she is. It's exactly the kind of music that I would expect from a 22-year-old.
Yeah, I agree.
It's, like, good but young and nostalgic.
Yeah.
Like, refreshing but still nostalgic at the same time, which I thought was interesting. And she has such a unique voice.
She does. And it's just, like, I was thinking about how I listened to it a couple, like, I listened to it a few times through, these past, for, here, I can't speak words. I listened to it a few times through, and then I really listened to it on my way, like, my drive back today, and I, like, really, like, put it into my brain. And, I was just thinking, I was like, some of these songs I feel a little... like, accosted by the beats. Like, they're the real... they're, like, too electronic for me to where it almost hurts my ears. I'm also very sensitive to sound, and I'm, like, instead of me turning down the volume, I just, like, was like, oh, my God. And it's, like, but, like, compared to the words and the way her voice sounds, I'm, like, this could be a little softer. Like, it was just too harsh.
Yeah.
And I feel like there was... I'm not saying that happened in every song, but there were some where I'm, like, I don't know. But I do... agree. I like how it's got the poppiness and the, like, bluesy, like, soulful-y kind of.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, she's not trying to be too pop with her voice. Like, her music is poppy, but her voice is not.
Yeah.
Which is interesting. There is one song. I think it might be, it's either Comfortable or A Little More. I can't remember. But it's one of those where, like, the way that she's singing doesn't match the way that the music is, and, like, I like the song, I like the lyrics. It's, like, it's one of those songs where I like the music and I like the lyrics separately.
I think it might have been Comfortable, because I feel like, because I remember she was, like, Inevitable, and I'm, like, yeah, I just remember that, like, being a little weird.
Yeah.
Because I, like, listening to it a little more, I was, like, this is cute. I think it was actually the one that I didn't like, might have been Not Today. I really liked the words to that, because, like, I can relate. But also, that was the one where I was like, this music is hurting my ears.
Yeah.
But
I also feel like the only thing that I don't like about this album is that I think a lot of the songs have a similar sound. Similar enough that it's, like, hard to tell songs apart. Like, the songs that I really love, obviously I know what their names are, but there's other songs in here where, like, you could be like, yeah, Not Today and All We Know, pick one. And I'd be like, well, I couldn't tell you which one's which.
Like, and it's not like she's... having, like, recurring, like, motifs. It's just, like, this just sounds the
same. This sounds.
You know?
Yeah.
But...
which, I mean, is something that happens on an album. Like...
it happens.
An album is a collection of songs that all fit together, so it's fine. It's just... that was just one of the very few things that I didn't like about the album.
Yeah.
I thought it was very good, though. And I like her. Did you see... I shared it on Facebook.
If it was on Facebook, I probably didn't. Because I do not check that.
She did... let me find it before I misspeak. Scroll through a bunch of our own things.
I literally only get on Facebook enough to, like... oh, I think I have seen that video before, though.
She did a thing with SiriusXM where she did a Destiny's Child mashup. It's so good.
Mm-hmm.
It's really, really
good. I think that might have surfaced on Twitter at some point, too.
Probably.
Because I remember seeing this. You know what else I really like about her? Hmm. She just kind of, like, it's just regular.
Yeah. Like, she's wearing a hoodie and, mm-hmm. like, minimal makeup on this.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's just, like, and I'm not saying that if you're a celebrity and you, like, you are, like, you know, you wear all name brand and all designer and all that kind of stuff. Like, that's fine. I'm not judging you for that. But I also, I like that because it's like, if I personally was a celebrity, I would still probably wear mostly only Goodwill.
Yeah.
And, like, what I have on right now.
Yeah.
Because it's comfortable and I feel good in it.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Also, me and Taylor match.
We do match.
So, anyway. we also haven't seen each other in, like, a month, so.
Yeah.
But
yeah, she's literally, oh, man. Hold on.
Yeah. She's got, like, wearing a scrunchie in.
Yeah. She's wearing jeans, like, mom jeans and a hoodie. Yeah. Real cute. I like her. Yeah. That's it. Pretty much. That's pretty much all I have to say. It's a good, solid 45-minute album.
Yeah. It was, I enjoyed listening to it on my drive back. That's one mm-hmm. of my New Year's resolutions. Oh, my God. We should talk about our resolutions in a minute.
I don't have any.
I can tell you mine, because okay. I made a lot, and you can just tell us how much of a shit show I am, because I have
too much pressure for me, so I don't do that anymore.
I need to fix myself as a person.
I was like, resolution. Do I want to hold myself to these standards? Not really.
Not really.
So I'm not going to do resolutions this year.
One of mine is to, one, discover more music, mm-hmm. and, like, I also kind of want to, like, fall into maybe a style of what I listen to. Mm-hmm. And I'm not saying I won't all, like, close myself off to other things. But, like, I just, my life is in, everything in my life is chaos. And it's, like, and I also want to listen to more albums mm-hmm. instead of just songs. That's one of my goals. So I enjoyed listening through the album. Like, on my drive home, it was just me and I could just, like, sit and listen to it and just kind of, like, And then I found myself crying. That was unrelated to this, though. Honestly, this is pathetic and so mushy and gross, and I'm sorry to everyone out there. I literally was just thinking about Luke and how just I like him so much, and I started crying. Like, but not just like, oh, I was like, like sobbing over Luke, and I'm like, you're gonna see him in like an hour, and you're gonna go get Chipotle, and I'm like. Sometimes I just do that.
That's okay.
And then I came home and was a hot mess.
That's okay.
Yeah.
I got to, Pixie greeted me with a nice bite to the knuckle.
Good.
So.
We took our cat to the shelter. We had to, I know, I'm sorry.
So sad.
I know.
Oh, I wanted her so bad.
We had a cat that, so when we moved, we took two of the dogs, and then we ended up getting the third dog, and then we ended up going back and getting the cat, from, you know, my ex-stepfather, which we don't, that's a whole, I'm not going to tell that story on here.
No.
And it doesn't matter. So we had to go get her because she was a declawed cat that had lived inside and he had put her outside.
No.
And so we're like, she can't be outside. She will die. Mm-hmm. So we went and we got her. And then we had three dogs and a cat in this tiny apartment, and it's already chaos. Like mm-hmm. I said, everything in my life is chaos. And so we tried to find her, and Taylor wanted her really bad.
Evan won't let me have a cat because I just want to put it at his apartment, and I'm only there on the weekends.
Yeah.
But like, it's 4 months until I move in, so just take care of the cat for 4 months, and then I'll take it.
Yeah.
I'll move it, and I'll move in, and I'll take care of her.
Right.
So we would have had to change her name because his grandma's name is Alice.
Yeah, that's fine.
I don't think cats know their name.
No. Well, but and we took her to the shelter today. But she's a long-haired white calico. She'll get adopted in like 30 seconds.
Well, yeah, and she's up to date on shots, declawed and spayed.
Right.
Perfect cat.
But Chris also wanted her, but that didn't work out either.
Well.
But it's okay.
Yeah.
Sad.
It's fine.
She's fine. She's okay.
Somebody go adopt her, please. Thanks.
Hey, if you live in that area of where I live, and I'm not going to say that and put it on the internet, go adopt my cat. The area where my family all resides.
As if we have any enemies.
I know.
I mean, maybe we do. Somebody's just like, ooh, I hate that color gray.
I mean,
they might hate this color.
We do know.
If you hate this color,
We do know a few odd people.
Sorry. We do know some odd people.
So, anyway. That went downhill quickly.
Well, sorry. Yeah. It's okay.
So, guess what we're doing next week, Taylor? We're going to do Retrofuturism by VHS Collection.
Shit, yeah.
Everything's broken. Yes. I'm glad we're here in this moment together. It's been so long. I've been away from you for so long. Yeah, it's if you've never heard of VHS Collection, check them out. If not, we're going to talk about them next week. This is an older album. It came out November 2nd of last year, 2018. So,
I mean, this came out November 30th.
Yeah, it's not really that old, but...
And you know what? We don't always have to do new music.
And you know what? This is our podcast, and we're going to do whatever we damn well please.
My podcast, not yours.
Yeah. Also, what's happening this weekend, Taylor?
The Bridge. First show is going to be happening. We'll put the poster here.
Yeah.
Our first artist is Lizzie Tremaine. She is from Northern Indiana. We went to the same high school. She was a senior when I was a freshman.
Mm-hmm.
And she makes, like, music, and she's really good. I totally expect her to, like, bring her keyboard and her bongos. Like, she's just really cool, you guys. So that'll be Saturday, January 12th.
Mm-hmm.
Go to the Boiler TV Facebook page. It will be live streamed, so don't miss it. And if you do miss it, don't worry, we're gonna archive them all so you can go back and watch everything. But our first show will be this upcoming Saturday, January.
We have two weekends in a row, right?
Yeah, and the next Friday will be Pat App.
Wait, no. Two Fridays from now. It's Memorial Day weekend, right? No, I wrote that in my calendar wrong.
Day weekend is like...
I know.
When school starts in August.
You know what I mean. MLK Day.
Is it?
I don't know. Anyway, stay tuned. You'll find out. First of all...
It's the 18th. No. Yeah, the 18th. Pat will be here on the 18th.
Okay. Then, yeah. Whatever. It's happening. It's all happening. We got a lot going on, and it's fun, and it's cool.
Yeah.
And I've got a lot going on in here. Like, my shelf just fell at my house, and my roommate texted me, hey, your shelf fell.
That's okay.
But it's all right.
My shower shelf falls all the time.
Oh, I'm really sad. I had a cool record leaning on it, and I was like, that's so cool. But
Evan's mom got me SZA's record.
Nice.
For Christmas.
I don't have a record player.
It's
I did have a record player, but it broke.
It's two, and they're both translucent, like a forest green color.
Nice.
And the middle label is like an orangish red.
Oh, cool. I need to get a cheap record. I have a lot of like old, like I have a Night at the Opera on vinyl. Like I need to get a record player. I had one, and the turntable was just like, I don't want to spin anymore, bitch. And it stopped, and I said, "Okay."
I have a Crosley like suitcase.
Mm-hmm. That's what I want, just like a.
Yeah, the only thing is, like, the number one complaint with those is that the table can become, like, loose almost. So sometimes it'll like bump, 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 but it's just like unbalanced.
Yeah.
And I only ever listen to my records when I'm cleaning, so it's not like it bothers me that much.
Yeah, I had like a big standing one that my dad got me, and it was like the old timey one with like the speaker on the front, but it also had like the aux import and the tape. And all that kind of stuff, but I'll probably just wait until I have an actual salary, hopefully.
And an apartment, that way you don't have to move it.
Right. Salary and an apartment and a life, which I'm applying for my first job tomorrow, so good luck. Wish us luck. Our lives are here.
I'm struggling. I have my resume made, I'm just really struggling with the cover letter.
Yeah. You can borrow mine if you want it.
Hi, I'm Leah. As if that's what you sound like.
Yeah. It was funny. Amelia was, like, writing hers the same time that I was writing mine. And so she sent me a PDF. And then we were, like, sending cover letters to each other and, like, freaking out.
But I had all three of our websites up earlier today. I was like, look at all of us at our website.
Look at all of us doing big things.
Mine's just old stuff.
Ugh. I mean, I spent literally an entire day just making my portfolio look like something. Because I had like 6 photo sets that had not been put on my website. And I'm like, if you let this get any more behind, you're just going to die.
Yeah.
So.
That's great.
But, all right. Should we wrap it up before I just start talking about...
Yeah. We probably should. All right, you guys, we will see you next Monday.
Follow our socials.
Yeah. Follow our socials. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, all of the above. You can find us on Music Monday Cast.
All right, that's it.
You can find us everywhere. If you're audio only, you can find us everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
There's an Anchor, specifically.
Anchor?
That's all.
We're going to get a drink with, that we forgot about this last weekend.
We're going to go get a drink with
Chris. Yeah, we're going to go drink with Chris.
In case you couldn't tell, we need one.
Yes. Okay, bye!